by myself, no radio. When I pulled out the driveway, I said, okay, God, it's me and you. Every church I passed had all the stuff about being thankful just because it's Thanksgiving. When I think about Thanksgiving, I'm thinking about the things I'm thankful for, but how much giving have I gave? So I challenged my husband last night. We were talking about giving blood. You know, why don't we give blood and be thankful for that? Why, how much can we give away and be thankful for it?
All right, God.
One Bible study, Pastor said, we're not thankful because we have so much. We have too much.
Yeah.
And I can testify, we have too much. If you look at my garage, I have so much that I know I ain't gonna never use. But just being selfish and won't give it away.
Right.
So for this Thanksgiving, I'm gonna reflect on being thankful for life, health, strength, family. But I also wanna be thankful for giving away as much as I can.
Amen.
And I just wanna challenge anybody else who would like to do the same with them. And happy Thanksgiving to everybody.
Amen. Thank God for our young people. Blessing our hearts with praises. And Sister Stacy, for we have to be reminded. We are at heart, we just selfish. Everything about me. What's in it for me? Garage is not even for cars anymore. Garage for my stuff. Cars stay outside. Wherever you can get, and I got to make room for a double car. Garage full of stuff. I'm gonna get to use it one of these days.
Yeah.
All right. All right. Isn't it good to be alive? Church, the Lord is so good. In spite of me, how messed up. Anybody messed up besides me? The Lord just keeps making the way. And I'm grateful.
There's a voice that cries out in the silence, searching for a heart that will love him, longing for a child that will give him that will give it all. Wants it all, and there's a God that walks over the earth. He's searching for a heart that is desperate and longing for a child that will give him their all, give it all. He wants it all, and he says, love me.
Serve me with your life.
I'm sorry.
Let's start at verse 3. Chapter 4 of 2 Corinthians, verse 3. But if our gospel be hidden, it's hidden from them that are lost. And the reason they're lost, in whom the God, the little G, the God of this world, this age, listen to that in mind, have blinded the minds of them who believe not, lest the light of the glorious gospel of Christ, who is the image of God, should shine unto thee. For we preach not ourselves, but Christ Jesus the Lord. And ourselves are servants for Jesus' sake. For God, who commanded the light to shine out of darkness,
well,
this reading I preach, have shined or have shown in our hearts to give the light of knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Jesus Christ. But we have this treasure in earthen vessels, that the excellency of the power may be of God, not of us. We are troubled on every side. Yeah, I got it. Now watch the but nots. Yet not distress. We, this a we thing now, are perplexed, but not in despair. Persecuted, but not forsaken. Cast down, but not destroyed. Always bearing about in the body the dying of the Lord Jesus, that the life also of Jesus might be made manifest in our bodies. Now, skip down to verse 16 of chapter 4. For which cause we faint not. But though our outward man perish, yet the inward man is renewed day by day. For our light afflictions, watch this, which is but for a moment. That's why you got them now, so that the afflictions worketh for us a far more exceeding and eternal weight of glory. While we look not at the things which are seen, but at the things which are, we able to see things that are not seen. For the things which are seen are temporal, but the things which are not seen, they seen, but they not seen, are eternal. Can I go one more verse? Verse 1 of chapter 5. For we know that if or since God our earthly house, but that is of this tabernacle, this tent, were dissolved. It's eternal in the heavens.
All right now.
verse 6, therefore, we're always confident, knowing that while we are at home in the body, we're absent from the Lord. For we walk by faith. We're confident, I say, and willing rather to be absent from the body, present with the Lord. I want to talk about trials and triumphs of ministry. Trials and triumphs in ministry. This second epistle, a letter to the Corinthians, Paul, who established this church at Corinth, ran into some folks that were criticizing his credentials as an apostle. He experienced some opposition inside the church. He ran into some critics inside the church. And we just got folks that's gonna be critical. I don't care what you do. Somebody is not gonna like it. Preachers, if the preacher is young, he likes experience. If he's old, he's out of touch. If he preaches from notes, he got a canned sermon. If he don't use no notes, he's unorganized. If he takes time with the poor, he's grandstanding. If he takes time with rich folks, he's cocky. If he condemns sin, he's being cranky. If he tells the truth, he's offensive. If he drives a new car, he's showing off. If he drives an old car, that's a shame. If he dress up, he's a show off. If he dress down, he ought to do better. You ain't gonna please folks. But Paul writes to us about a specific group of people, and he calls them the we know people. We know. We not guessing. We know.
We know.
We not trying to know. We know.
We know.
I'm not expecting to know. We know right now.
We know.
That if our earthly house, now that if means since. But you sitting here looking at me, and if you got any sense at all, you know these old bodies is wearing out. I mean, if you can think at all, you've already come to the conclusion, these old bodies, I know the young folks, they say, what are you talking about? Hang around. Just stick around a little while. And you're going to find out, like all most of us have already found out that this earthly house is dissolved. Paul tells us about an outer man and an inner man. I'm not talking about being schizo, but there are two of me. There are two of you in the same house if you've been born again. Now, if you haven't been born again, it's just one of you. This physical house, this tent, you know, a tent not permanent anyway. It's a temporary tent. It's called the outer man.
All right now.
There's no pill. There's no injection. There's no oil. There's no rub. There's no medicine to keep you or me from getting old. Your steps. Somebody ought to say amen. It's going to get short. Your eyes. Going to need some adjustments. But Charlie, you go from bifocal to trifocal. Making adjustments. Your hearing. One of the most popular words, say, huh? Your hearing.
All right now.
Gonna get bad too. Now, I guess I should go ahead and let you know When you accept Christ as your Savior, this new man, the spiritual man, is born inside. But the old you don't die.
All right, now.
So Gwen, there's a Sister Gwen and a Gwendolyn.
All right.
Gwendolyn is a tough sister. Are y'all with me? And a brother Mike and a Michael. I ain't talking about the archangel either. There's a Pastor Young and Arthur Ray. Are y'all with me? There's a Sister Chili and a Chili. Chili Chili. On the inside.
Yeah. All right, now.
When Arthur Ray and Pastor Young start warring with one another. And I want to blame everybody else for what's going on, but it's in me. That outward man is perishing, but the good news is the inner man, the spiritual man, God is renewing it. Day by day. Now, he says he's renewed. Renewed is different from being reformed. Renewed is not rehabilitated. When you reform or rehabilitate, you're working with the same stuff. There's no improvements. Well, let me put it like this. Have you ever told yourself what you were and were not going to do anymore? I mean, you don't have to, you know. You told you. I'm not going to do that. You remember? And as soon as you got on the corner of opportunity and desire. Everybody ever been on the corner of opportunity and desire? See, a whole lot of things you don't do because you ain't had the opportunity. You got the desire. But when opportunity and desire meet up on the corner, you going one way or the other. And if you don't have no Holy Ghost, I'm talking about in me right now, there's no way I got strength enough to yield not to temptation. Because I want to do it. Amen. And the reason I want to do it, I like to do it. We really won't be honest. But the reason why we sin and keep on sinning, you like it. God don't.
Thank you.
facilitators. And I'm going to tell you something else, too. He's not talking about turning over no new leaf. Turning over, I don't know what that means, a new leaf.
Yeah.
No, he's talking about a whole nother book.
Yeah.
When he gives you a new life,
all right,
gives you a new beginning. And he, along with the new life comes a new walk. Now, when I say, when the scripture says a new walk, your foot's the same size. Your feet. You know, and if you were pigeon-toed at first, you're still pigeon-toed. Because we take things literally when we should be taking them spiritually. He's not talking about changing your physical walk. He's talking about changing the places you go with your same feet. The attitude you take with your same feet. How you treat other people. That's the walk. And when the walk is changed, the talk is changed. Anybody experience the Lord changing your conversation? Then you got a new master. You got some new friends. You got some new enemies. And he's taking you to a new home. But then on our way to our new home, he said, listen, we are trouble. Y'all hear this?
Yeah.
On every side.
Yeah.
Maybe I'm the only one. But have you ever experienced trouble come and look like from all directions? Well, how many sides we got? Have you ever tried to count them? Left, right, front, back, up, down, round, anymore? Don't try to count the side. He already told you it's coming from every side. And trouble will come from where you least expect it to come. Things just going on smooth. And the telephone rang. Or you run into somebody. But listen, even though we are troubled on every side, he says, yet not. Thank God for the yet not. I'm not distressed. Even in my trouble, God has given us a comfort. This walk with the Lord, this peace, this joy, this contentment that God gives us is not the absence of trouble. It's peace in the midst of trouble. It's peace when trouble all around you. It's peace that even I don't understand why I ain't mad. Somebody ought to get cussed out. Look like that ought to be right to something. Say something.
All right, down.
Then the Lord just got it. with trouble.
Yes, in trouble.
Yet not distressed. Can I go on?
Right now.
We are perplexed. But not in despair.
No, no.
I really don't know how to handle this. I got a situation I don't know which way to go. But I ain't worried about it.
No, no.
I ain't pulling my hand. You talking about jumping off the bridge? I walk to the last step and look at you. Because I'm learning that when you trust in the Lord, won't it come through? When you try. Because I don't care what you're going through, it's going to change. It's going to change, church. If it's good, it's going to change. If it's bad, it's going to change. If it's right, it's going to change. If it's wrong, it's going to change. If it's sunshine, it's going to change. If it's raining, it's going to change. If it's cold, it's going to change. Since I know it's gonna change, and I know trouble don't last always, I'm just gonna wait till my change comes. I'm gonna stand right here. Wait on him, church. Am I talking to anybody? And he goes on to say, persecuted. Another but not. Persecuted. Folks talk about you. Oh Lord. And I got to hurry up and close this message, but listen. Hear me good. When you decide to live for the Lord, when you decide to live right to the best of your ability, look for Jesus said. If you're going to follow me, you're going to be talked about. You're going to be persecuted. You're going to be misunderstood. So don't get all bent out of shape when you pass by folks you ain't done nothing to and they just roll their eyes at you. That's part of it. When you pass by folks, we had some folks, my wife told me the other day, that moved in next door. And we've been speaking to them for 2 weeks now. And they've been looking. And I told them, I said, well, maybe they don't understand English. I mean, when you say, hey! If people, listen to me, wake up in the morning and God wake them up and watched over them all night and they wake up in the morning and don't speak to God, who are you? Who am I?
All right,
persecute. That means that's when you're pursued by the enemy. Had the enemy ever got on your train? Yeah. Had hellhound ever got behind you? Oh, he's a hiding place. He's a refuge and our strength. And he says we are cast down, but not destroyed. Yes, the enemy got me down, but he couldn't knock me out. You knocked me down, but I ain't gonna let you knock me out. You might strap me down, but I haven't struck out yet. For the Lord is able to raise you up. And then in this walk with the Lord, Paul teaches us a Christian is really strongest when he's weakest. He's really stronger when you acknowledge you're weak.
All right, God. All right, God.
And we try to be too strong. Try to lean to your own strength. But somebody put it in a song, and they went on to testify, I am weak, but thou art mighty. Hold me with your powerful hand. So here we are in this ministry. We've got this treasure in earthen vessels. We got this vessel that's deteriorating. And then we've got trouble on every side. But then he says here, here's what you do. Don't faint. Don't fall out. Just hold on. Anybody know what I'm talking about? To God, unchanging hand. He says, for while we pass through here, we're in a tabernacle, and everything you see is temporary. But God got some things for us eyes haven't seen, ears haven't heard, haven't even entered into the heart of man. What God's got in store for us. Well, what does he have? I'm glad you asked. We know. We know. I ain't guessing about it. And the reason why I'm so sold on we know, because Jesus told me if it were not so, I never would have told. We know that since this earthly house, this tent is, I like that word, dissolved. Y'all know what dissolve mean? Dissolve. That's a good one. Alka-Seltzer. Y'all with me? You put it in the water. You put a pill, what looked like a pill, in the water. And it fizzes up. It might look like it's gonna jump out the glass. It ain't going nowhere. And as soon as it fizzes up, it settles back down to nothing. You know, life is similar to that. While you're young, jump out the glass. But just hang around a little while. And them same feelings settle down. And shut up. While it's in there, just be shh. And I found out as I get older, time will teach you to shut up. We got a building. And a house. Now, the reason why we need one, flesh and blood can't enter. And church, every time I think about it, I just get happy.
All right,
that God loves us so not only has he prepared a place, he fixed another body. Ooh, y'all. And this new body, this new one he got prepared. Maisha, it don't hurt. I mean, no pain, nowhere. It don't even get old. Now, I've been trying to figure out how God's going to do that. Whatever age I die at, how, what age will I come back? I don't know. Whatever age, if some of you feel a little bit like me, it won't matter. Because I'll be so happy not to hurt. Whatever age it is. And then we're told no more sorrow, no more funerals, no doctors, no liars, no homeowners, and the wicked will cease from trouble, and the weary. Oh, ain't be no night there. Because the glory of God. Won't we ever have to say, I'll see you later no more.
Right
now. Now, our problem is how to deal with this trouble on every side, and how to deal with not getting out of the race. Church, he's made a way. All he asks us to do is trust and depend on him. Because some of us, and it's rightfully so, are skeptical about yourself. And you got a right to doubt you. What if I go up there and say I want to commit my life to the Lord and can't make it? Well, I'm going to tell you up front, by yourself you can't make it. It's not up to you to make it. It's up to you to trust and obey. We studied last week about the children of Israel crossing the Red Sea. And the scripture said that God put a wall of water up on each side. And they looking at the water. And he told them, go through. Come on through. And I see them, some of us now say, what if I get halfway across this water and this thing sprang a leak? What if something happened? Church, put your what ifs, give them to God. Put all of your what ifs in his hand. He know you got them. And let him fix them for you. But for right now, don't you think it's time to make a commitment to walk with the Lord?
All right now.
He knows your situation, and he still loves you. But church, if I don't ever come to him, how can I ask him to help me? And God don't have no secret disciples. Because if you're ashamed to own him, I want to give you another opportunity. Do you hear me? Not so much a join in church, but coming to Jesus. Let the trouble, let the winds blow. We've got a Savior that's able to say peace. be still.
All right now.
So even though the storms keep raging, if you trust and never doubt, he'll bring you out. So if you're here this morning, you want to surrender your will and your way to the Lord, you'll never regret. You will never regret. You will never regret accepting Christ as your Savior. Then you'll have eternity to regret not accepting Christ. So if you're here, would you come?
Scraps, 7.25 an hour, nothing pretty much, no busting my bottle, just to try to make an honest living, minding my business. And it's kind of like, I just been sitting back, just watching how the devil operate. You know, and I'm like, you want my attention that bad? You know? I see how he orchestrate things, and I don't really like it. They say walk in faith. I've been walking in faith since I got baptized here 5 months ago. I don't know if my face looked familiar, but I thought I could do it on my own. I was wrong. I can't do it on my own. You know, I may thank God every now and then, but I need to thank him every day. And my pops, Brother Turan, told me it's going to be the biggest battle of my life. And he's right. And this is pretty much the biggest battle I've ever been through. You know, so I'm here to tell the church home, and church family, that I need prayer. And whatever you, I'm just glad to be here. Thank you.
Listen. Thank God for the 725 job.
Amen.
Little becomes much. Listen to me good. When you place it in the master's hand, can't nobody stretch a dollar like the Lord. He'll stretch it so that face on the dollar, his face. Listen, trust him. Stay off the devil's ground. That he's put in you, you've got to nurture it. It has to be matured. It's got to grow. And it only grows spiritually through the word of God. Now listen. You're doing the right thing. You're at the right place. You're coming to the right Savior to walk in the right path. You're climbing the right tree on the right street. Stay with the Lord.
Amen.
I understand. We love you. We're here for you. Granny loves you. Daddy loves you. Your relatives love you. Your church family loves you. Okay. You grow in grace. Faith cometh by hearing the word of the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
I got you some. This is step number one. Our lesson for this morning, we're going to start in Luke, starting Tuesday. That's the birth of Jesus. Church,
my Uncle Bo and my Aunt Nana take me in because I couldn't get a ride from the hospital. I had to walk all the way from Northeast, Humble, Texas, to get to LBJ. I couldn't get nobody to pick up the phone to come school for you after I was in J5. No one lost my life, so I want to thank you on the phone. I want to be there to come to
the rest of the day. Amen. And I'm going to tell you this. Our God always got somebody to help us. Do you hear me? Always got some help. Might not be who you expect, but he's always got some help. If he wouldn't always be a help, he couldn't tell us he would be a present help in the time of trouble. He ain't gonna lie. relationship with the Lord serious. I'm seeing too many young funerals. 20, 25. And Satan wants to kill you. He ain't playing with you. But I pray that you let God be real in your life. All right, now, don't forget this week, we're going to have our midweek service Tuesday. Then we'll have our Thanksgiving service Thursday from 10 until 11. We ought to swing these doors open and come in here saying thank you for all of his many blessings towards. Matter of fact, you ought to start saying thank you today. We're going to pray as we close this service. And if there's anybody here that desire to sign your name on this prayer by coming to the altar, you're welcome to do so. But I do want you to know God is a prayer hearing. And if you reel with God, God will be real with you. Lord, help us today.
Is supposed to be. trusted God. So now we turn it over to you. Have your way, God. Father, work on us from the inside out. Thank you for it right now, Lord. Every one of us.